This is the Hope Community Center in Apopka, Florida. It's nice enough on the outside, but what's really special happens inside. The scope and depth of programs offered at the Hope Center is remarkably diverse.
I think our core work is bringing people together, and I think that's what the Hope Community Center does.
Sister Ann Kendrick is one of the founders of the Hope Community Center.
I think we're privileged, those of us that work here at the Hope Center, to be a part of that process of empowerment and community building. It's really a gift.
The Hope Center acts as an agent for social change and empowerment.
Yeah, I think the Hope Center is a bridge. It's a connector.
Collaboration is batted around a lot. You hear people talking about that a lot. And it's messy work, and it's not always easy, and it's not always fun. You know, working with people who come from different places, have different cultures, different experiences, do things differently, that's not easy.
But people at the Hope Center accept differences. They look up to those that others might look down on. It's their own pledge of allegiance to each other.
I've never seen a place where people are so dedicated to not only within their community, but outside of the community, and helping people that are different, are diverse, and are different cultures, different aspects of life. And that's humanity. That's beautiful.
Janello Germain is an 18-year-old volunteer tutor at the Hope Center. She knows the struggles of poverty.
Great.
I could, you know, relate. And everyone has their own struggles. Everyone struggles different. I go times without water and electricity and things like that, but I make it. They make it, and it's life.
The Hope Center is a learning community, a place where quietly and efficiently, people are learning to read, write, and speak English. In the family nurturing and counseling programs, families are learning communication skills and how to cope in this new environment. They are gaining knowledge to become U.S. citizens.
Who is in charge of the executive branch?
The president. The president.
Who makes federal laws?
Congress.
There are computers here where people can look for jobs or learn a new language. The Hope Center is committed to immigrant rights, advocacy, and education. We also help find social services for those in need. Youth here are discovering how to treat others with love and respect. They're learning leadership skills and traveling a path to continuing their educations. Teens who participate in Hope's youth enrichment programs have a 2% high school dropout rate compared to the average high school dropout rate of 12%. 70% of our high school graduates are enrolled in post-secondary education, college, or technical programs. More than 400 volunteers provided almost 65,000 hours of service at the Hope Center last year. Sue Shetram is a volunteer teaching Sylvia Garcia so she can get her GED.
I have always been a teacher. It's just part of me. When she brings her children, when they're off. I want to teach them,
like
too.
Like last week.
Yeah. I just love seeing people learn.
I'm doing this for me, but at the same time, this is going to help my kids because I will be able to help them with their, you know, their homework.
Every year, the Hope Community Center hosts Notre Dame AmeriCorps members. They come from all over the world to fan out into Orange, Seminole, and Volusia counties. Laura Fertel directs the AmeriCorps group for the Hope Center.
We get an infusion of energy and creativity and skill and heart. And they come because they have a heart to serve, and because they see something in this community. They don't just see the limitations of the community, but they see the values.
Donna Wilcox is one of those Notre Dame AmeriCorps members.
The Hope Community Center looks at each individual and says, what do you have to bring? And whatever it is that you have to bring, bring it, because we can use it. Is your talent making awesome guacamole? Bring your guacamole. Is your talent playing with children or being able to work with babies? Bring that. They don't look at what you don't have. They help you to realize what you do have and what you can bring.
You've got something you feel passionate about, something that you can do, come help us. You could teach it. You could be with other people and help them catch the fire that you have for the thing that you love.
I think every day here, we have a little miracle.
Milka Melendez is the Director of Youth Services and Conscience of the Hope Center.
Everybody is a human being, but at the same time, you know, we are the people of God. And the gospel sent us to work with those, with the poor. But for me, this place is the great opportunity to live the gospel.
Here you can come and say, you know, I can trust these people.
Carlos Acosta was 15 years old when he crossed the Rio Grande.
I mean, it was difficult for me to, 15 years old, walking towards the States, you know, crossing the border. But I didn't know what I was doing. I mean, but at the same time, I had no choice. You know, my parents were here, so they wanted something better for me. I didn't understand till I got here.
Married now with a young daughter, he stepped into a leadership role for other young parents.
This has helped me a lot. I mean, I'm a young parent. I'm only 20 years old, and I never knew how to be a father. I mean, it doesn't come with a manual, but for me, it's very touchful that the other people that believe in you, that thanks to you, are very parents. I mean, they're not the best. I mean, we're not perfect, but they try their best, and you see the difference, you know.
Filomeno and Valentina Romero are parents to 6 children. They are great supporters of the Hope Center.
They don't put any obstacles or barriers to get help. Whether you have money or don't have money, they are just welcoming and help you with whatever you need.
Filomeno is now a U.S. citizen. His 2 daughters are attending college with scholarships from the Hope Center, and their mother is attending the mom's class.
I'm
happy because I'm getting to go to school. I want to learn and improve myself.
It is awesome for them because they are learning, and, you know, we never stop learning, and I think that's good for them. And, you know, for my mom, for us to feel proud of her that she's going there and she's trying her best.
We have a very important and core program at the Hope Center called Service Learning, which is actually the container that holds all of our programs.
Service learning is a strategy for social change where through service we learn and through learning we serve. For example, college students from communities of privilege like Harvard and Duke come to live with local immigrant or farm worker families and see and feel what it's like to work the fields.
Their service is getting to know a community and getting to have a relationship with that community and then being allies with that community for the rest of their life.
Hope Community gives people voices.
J.P. Griffin is a local philanthropist working primarily for women and children.
The biggest reason I support Hope is because they're my church. They are the real church to me. Hope Community has helped me and my family quite a bit over the years. And I thought I was going to be helping them. And it's really great to learn that if we open ourselves up to being helped, we will be, and I am.
You have hope here, hope.
It's beautiful. I don't know, I don't have the words to describe this center.
It's love to each other, you know, love, I would say.
Amazing, amazing. I wish I could like make up another word.
The name that they have is a hope. It's a hope for everything. Hope for the people, hope for freedom.
Say love. That's really what it's all about, love.
Thank you so much for transforming so many lives. Thank you.
I love the Buddhist, you know, thought that they, you know, it's all fine in the 700-year plan. You know, I like the thought of a 700-year plan. It just does take the pressure off.